Nothing is sacred for these insane imbeciles, nothing. And yet they enjoy the support of celebrities, including world-class hypocrite and racing car driver Lewis Hamilton, who likes lounging on private jets. Oh, presumably they're fueled by renewable unicorn dust. And of course, the Formula One star also has a super yacht to go along with all the high-powered cars and the private jet. And here is the climate crusader proudly wearing the names of his sponsors, including major sponsor Petronas. Guess what they do, Rowan? They're in the oil business. In fact, they're Malaysia's state-owned oil company. Just stop oil, Lewis, really? And look, there's another prominent sponsor there, Ineos. Guess what they do? Well, yes, they're an oil and gas company. Of course they are. But there seems to be very little cost for the likes of Lewis Hamilton and his idiotic empty virtue signalling. Indeed, there can be an upside. And there certainly has been some upside for a major Just Stop Oil donor, Dale Vince, who, according to Daily Skeptic, has collected some £110 million in taxpayer subsidies over the past 20 years for his various alternative energy ventures. But increasingly, corporates are finding out that they can, well, there can be a cost for their leftist politicking. We've all heard about the billions lost by Disney, Bud Light, Target, after they engaged some in ill-advised leftist activism. And now perhaps Ben & Jerry's is going to pay a price too. The mediocre ice cream brand is no stranger to activism. And this week they marked Independence Day with this Twitter post saying, "It's high time we recognise that the US exists on stolen Indigenous land and commit to returning it." Well, it seems that bit of anti-American sentiment might cost Ben & Jerry's. Not only are there calls for a boycott as the parent company's share price falls, but they are now being asked to live up to what they're preaching about the US existing on stolen land that must be returned. An Indigenous tribe descended from the Native American nation that originally controlled the land in Vermont that Ben & Jerry's headquarters is located on, well, they want their land back. The chief of the Nulhegan Band of Cusack Abenaki Nation told Newsweek they wanted to reclaim stewardship of their lands, but Ben and Jerry's had failed to approach them. Imagine my shock here. And we're not immune to this type of corporate virtue signalling right here. In fact, with the referendum, it's running hot in Australia. Perhaps it's time that good people stopped handing over their hard-earned to companies that hate them, or at least hate their values. Perhaps then corporates would stick to their core business instead of trying to sway public policy, elections, and even referendums.